Hey folks, it's Liatin, the game coordinator for Smash Brothers, and I just want to go over kind of the procedure for how a game goes, how a match goes every Tuesday and Thursday. So, a couple considerations real quick. A match is made up of five sets. So, there are five sets in a match, and a set is the best of three games. Yes, a match is best of five. But we're asking that all five get played. Even if the first three you lose, we would like you to continue and play the other two, just for stats and just so everyone gets their opportunity to play. Each set must be played with a different person. You cannot have people repeat sets. If you do not have five people, then you're going to have to forfeit the sets that you don't have. If you have any concerns, questions or anything throughout on Tuesdays or Thursdays, please contact me via email or on Discord, and I will be definitely available to answer any questions. I am usually kind of streaming on Tuesday, but I have kids helping me out, so that won't be a problem. Thursdays, I'm usually at home because my assistant coach, JV coaches, handle those days, and but I will be available. I'm definitely making myself available for answering any questions, any of that sort of things. So, beginning of the match. When we're on the schedule, there's, the two teams are listed. The first team in the front is the home team. Home team makes the arena, and it will invite the visiting team. In the previous video, I showed you guys how to create an arena. Most of the kids know how to do it. Rely on them. Communication over Discord, Google Meet, or some other media is important. I know at Random Lake, I usually run the communication to try to talk about bans and that sort of thing, kind of what we're going to work through in this. This year may be a little different because I'll also be streaming, but have your captain or whoever, communicate. Discord's the great option. If you need to do a Google Meet, you can set one up or some other option. Reach out to the advisors to set that up ahead of time. So, you've got your home team one and home team two and visiting team one. Your number ones are ready to go. The first step is to decide the starting stage. The allowed state starter stages are Battlefield, Final Destination, Pokemon Stadium 2, Town and City, and Smashville. So, how this works is your home team's going to ban one stage. So, we'll say in this example, they're banning Smashville. The visiting team will then ban two other ones. Let's say they're banning Battlefield and Final Destination. That'll leave two stages left, Pokemon Stadium 2 and Town and City. The home team will then choose which one of those two they want. Once that's chosen, they will then both players will then go in on their switches and select that ban on the switch. I mean that, I'm sorry, that stage on the switch. If by some reason that stage that is selected was not the one that comes up because someone accidentally clicked the wrong one, that set is void and you remake the set. It is not a forfeit or anything. That those things happens. Then at that point, once the stage is selected, the players then pick their characters and they play the game. Now, game ends. Let's say home team wins. So what happens at that? Is the home team player will just say if they're changing characters and who they're changing to if they want. So we'll say home team player isn't changing. Then the home team player, who is the winning player, will ban two stages. So that includes the starter stages here, Battlefield, Final Destination, Pokemon Stadium 2, Town and City, and Smashville, as well as Yoshi's Story, Small Battlefield, Kalos, Pokemon League, and Lilac Cruise. They'll ban two. The losing player will then pick the stage. So, visiting team two will pick a stage. Let's say they pick Lilac. And then the losing player will also announce if they're changing characters. We're going to say they're not. They then play the game. If the visiting player wins, then the visiting player would say if they're changing characters, ban two stages, and the home team player would then choose a stage. The home team player would not be able to choose, like I think it was Pokemon Stadium 2, we said that was the stage that they picked. They would not be able to choose a stage that they had won in the first game. So they have to pick something different. So once all three games, or two or three games are played, once a winner is decided, you yourself need to kind of keep track and record that, because in the roster sheet there is a 1v1 record thing, so you can keep track. So we can kind of try to keep track of, may possibility for individual awards gives us that option for stats. Then second players will be up. And we're going to start over here at the beginning. The only difference, as I stay here, the only difference is instead of the home team stars, the winning team. So let's say home team, the visiting team ended up winning that third match. The visiting team would then be the one starting this ban out for the starting stage. So they would ban one stage, and then home would ban two, and then visiting would pick that. That's the process with it, and you'll go through and do that for all five of your games. And then once you know who won, be it home or visiting, the winning team will go on to the WIHSEA website and record the match results and the match results and the match reporting page. As always, if you have any questions, we'll go back here. You can email me at ellitson@rolladvantage.org. You can get me on Discord. If you pull up the stuff in the roster sheets, my phone number is there. If I don't answer, I get it emailed to me. Just reach out. I'll try to talk you through it. We can get on Google Meet and I can kind of walk you through it. So, thanks very much, guys. Have a hope the competition goes really well starting today and throughout the next few weeks.